Do you have a safe with no known combination? Today we're going to discuss how you get in. This is Acme Locksmith and you're watching Locksmith Recommended. At Acme Locksmith, we hear one question over and over: I don't have my safe combination, how do I get in? Often, the combination has been lost or is locked inside the safe, it happens. Or, the owner may have recently discovered that there is a safe in the home they just purchased and they want to begin using it. This is common with in-floor safes. To get into a safe, you can use a locksmith to 1. Get an override key. 2. Retrieve the combination. 3. Break into the safe quickly. 4. Drill the safe open professionally and then repair it. The first step in all of these methods is to get as much information as you can about the safe. Get your safe's brand and model number. You will need it so the locksmith can research it. The brand is usually the easiest to find. Most of the time, manufacturers put this on the door of the safe. Many manufacturers also put the serial number on the bottom corner of the front door. Model numbers can be trickier. Most manufacturers are placing model number on the back of the safe. So if your safe is bolted down or too heavy to move, you may not be able to get a model number. But don't worry, if you found the serial number, a locksmith can usually get all the information about your safe from the manufacturer. What is a locksmith looking for with this information? 1. Whether an override key is available. Some safe manufacturers, typically inexpensive safes, provide a key as a second method to get into the safe. If there is a key override, your local locksmith may be able to get a copy of it or make one from scratch. 2. How expensive is the safe? If the safe is cheaply made, think big box store safes, they are not worth the time and money to professionally drill and repair. It would cost more than simply replacing the safe. When this is the case, the locksmith can help by breaking into the safe quickly. 3. Retrieving the combination. If the safe is a dial, and you were able to find the serial number, the locksmith may be able to retrieve the original combination to the safe. Most safe manufacturers will not provide this data over the phone to a consumer, so you will need a locksmith. The locksmith acts as a security barrier for the manufacturer and will come to your location to verify you are the owner before trying the combination out. So long as the combination has never been changed, this will open the safe. The locksmith will then be able to reset the safe combination for you. 4. Obtain an electronic combination override. If your safe has an electronic lock, the safe serial number or the serial number of the electronic safe lock itself can be used to see if there is a master override code for the safe. Entering the override code will reset the electronic lock so that the lock's default combination will work. Here again, this information is not provided directly to a consumer. Your local locksmith will need to go to the location of the safe and verify you are the owner of the property the safe is in. 5. Knowing where to drill. As a last resort, your safe can be drilled when the combination has been lost. With the model and serial number, the locksmith can get the drill points of the safe and know exactly where to drill to not trigger any of the safe's security measures. Once open, the safe can then be repaired and function like new. These are the 4 possible options to get into your safe without a combination. If you've learned something from this video, please click the like button below and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching Locksmith Recommended.